Thanks for staying up with us. I'm Ariana Lake, and this is Nightside. A burglar armed with a knife found himself staring down the barrel of a loaded gun. Deputies say a homeowner found 40-year-old John Cravens inside his garage. Even with that gun pointed at him, Cravens decided to pull out a knife and make his own threats. That's when the homeowner fired his weapon. He spoke exclusively to Kyle Simchuk and shared what happened next. Kyle?
Well, that victim says he was prepared to kill Cravens to protect his own family. He fired two warning shots from his .22 caliber pistol. It sent a clear message to this suspected burglar.
If it would even have got closer to me, it would have been the end of him.
Holding an armed burglar at gunpoint, this Spokane Valley homeowner found himself in a tense standoff.
I wasn't going to get hurt. I wasn't going to let anybody get hurt. If I had to do it, I would have done it.
This man asked us not to share his identity, so we'll just call him Aaron. He was leaving for work early Monday morning and ran back in his house near Locust and Broadway for a few minutes. Once outside again, Aaron realized someone was in his garage.
And I called my brother and I said, hey, something, call 911. Ran back in, got the pistol, and he was still in the garage. And I said, hey, you mother. I said, you better come out here. He doesn't say a word. And then he starts talking, oh, I'm hungry, I'm homeless.
Even with a loaded gun pointed at his head, deputies say the burglar, John Cravens, pulled out his knife.
He panicked. He came out and started doing this, and I went, don't do that.
That's when Aaron sent a final warning.
I didn't want to shoot and ricochet here. I didn't want to shoot over towards the houses, so I shot towards my maple tree. I just went whap, whap.
He says Cravens dropped the knife and took off.
The cops came, and I said, he just ran through the yard if you want to put the dog on it, and they did, and they caught him in the bushes right over there, and the dog got him.
Canine Bane, to be exact. Once in custody, deputies asked Aaron to positively identify Cravens. He says that wasn't hard based off what he was wearing.
He had black spandex on, pants, had a black coat, black hair, and he had a ponytail.
Aaron says he's glad no one was hurt and that he had his gun close by.
Another one off the streets. Hope you're in there a long time.
And deputies say Craven has a long history of arrest stretching 18 years. He remains in jail charged with burglary and second-degree assault. Craven's declined our request for an interview. Chris.